Welcome back to the Fallen Returns. Last week you all headed up to Kaimalar, but not without saying hello once again to Fioriel, who looked much more worn than you remembered her seeing. She's been on the path trying to find where this ancient massive dragon that was once served the Fallen One, where the portal to the Shadowfell that he was currently sealed in. She had essentially narrowed it down to two, apparently going to the northeast, figuring that there is a Shadowfell portal over that way, and perhaps maybe finding the mythical city of Ilalina. After departing, you guys head up to Kaimalar, where you heard tales of a white apparition that liked to bounce about in the grove as if waiting for someone. You all went to investigate it, whereupon you discovered that indeed it was waiting for someone, was waiting for you all. After leading you into the forest, you ran into the Lady of the Grove, who turned out to be a unicorn, bestowing Corin his Dawn's Grace, a mace of great power, and also revealing Tamar's father, who had been missing since his childhood. Reunited once again, tearful moments were exchanged. Father and son finally reunited. You all left the grove. And Connor, playing the diplomat, managed to forge a sort of treaty with Kaimalar to move his troops forward. And then was offered a Werther's original, because this guy's obviously a grandfather. If he was a grandmother, it would be the strawberry hard candy. Anyway, you all then took a ride on a teleportation circle and ended up at the Greenbrier Collective, where the professor is the master of evocation. After scaring the portal attendant shitless,
yes,
and Corin falling flat on his ass.
Yes, I remember that too. That was
you
awesome.
All head towards the professor's office, which he has not been to in a while. Thanks for bringing that down, Kyle. You all enter his study where he starts to pour tea, and then you find the door knocking. The professor opens it to find a grouchy ass elven man standing in the doorway with only one eye glaring at you all, saying to the professor, "We need to talk." And that is where we're starting off.
Uh-oh, professor, I think he's going to break up with you.
Corin,
quiet.
Adults are talking. Elendar, what is the matter?
You tell me. You go missing for a century, then all of a sudden, drop me a note, and more notes, and then I had to sit here and figure which poor asshole was going to be the one to tell your wife that you were alive, and then I had to figure out first if that was actually you or someone was trying to impersonate you, in which case then I had to see if you were a double agent, a sleeper agent, a doppelganger. That was fun. And then once we figured out it was you and that you were somehow alive and well and just had not contacted us a while, then I had to try to break it to your wife. Keyword, try. So yes, I'm well, how are you?
Well, first of all, I didn't know that everyone thought I was dead. I didn't know. And I take the little stone out and I chuck it at him. Like, perhaps your eye could have seen that and helped me a little more. I don't appreciate the attitude, Elendar. I have been through a lot. I do appreciate telling my wife, though. Thank you. I did get to see her. That was good on you. But still, the attitude, Elendar. There's a lot going on.
I know there's a lot going on.
Yes, then why are we having this argument? call the council?
Because they have already been called. They're currently getting themselves together. I have talked to Evan Shield to drag up any information she can. I have just been holding this in for months. Fine. It's good to have you back.
Thank you. It's nice to have 100 years back. I have lots of issues, but we'll deal with them one at a time.
Don't we all?
But yes, but some of us aren't graced with the ability to see some of those before they happen.
He shrugs. They should be assembled now. All except for your wife. She's chasing down a lead on the hag at the moment.
Yes. We'll let her do that.
I'm not going. I learned my lesson after I told her you were alive.
You stay away from Allie when she has her mind set on something.
Oh, yeah. Just a bit. But, after the council meeting, you might want to go see Miss, Evan Shield.
Oh, I intended to. She's probably the only one that will have any good information. Or at least know where to find information.
Probably. I told her a thing, and you know how she is about certain things.
No.
I had to back the fuck out.
Yes. I'll before we go in, I'll tell the others about her. Is Victoria here?
As far as I know.
She'll be at the council. We may need to ask her for use of the Greenbrier specialities. I don't know why we're talking in code here. These are all my friends, Elendar. I am so rude. Please, let me introduce you to Erendir, there, over there in the corner. Connor. It's okay. He's with us.
He's the king of Tal Ren.
Yes. The mouth is Corrin. Talmar the paladin. Rael and Kaladin the dwarf.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh, and yes, Talmar's father. Who we worked with before.
That is true. I was wondering what had happened to you. And you see him sort of kind of a long story, and Mad-Eye holds up a hand and goes, "We'll discuss it later. Do me a favor and go talk to Evan Shield to make sure she hasn't sitting there and going and squeeing in a corner. You know how halflings get." And he just puts up his hands and go, "Yep, nope. I'll take care of that." And he looks at you, Talmar, and it's like, "I'll catch up with you later."
Absolutely. We all have a halfling in our life.
He slaps his shoulder and he goes out, heading towards the library.
That hurt.
Very well. We're going to meet the council, everyone. I felt it would be smart to tell them of our situation. And from here, I would like to peruse the library for some information. We have quite a lot of contacts, and it might be some time to sort through things, but whatever you feel we need to do here as well, any questions you might have, allow me to address the council, and then we can put it all out on the table.
Great.
Very well, Elendar.
Any help you need in the library, Professor, I can probably give you a hand.
When we go into the library, do not touch anything. Not me, it's the librarian. Kristana is very particular about her library. Just let you know. Don't
worry, Professor, you'll never see me laying hands on a book.
Good.
I would actually expect you to go mess up her Dewey Decimal System or something.
Oh. You mean except the one you were reading before, Corin?
That one didn't count.
Okay.
Because I said so.
That was before he made that rule, Ryan.
Yeah, exactly. I made that up right now.
I should have known. My apologies.
Yes, well, don't touch anything. I'm just seriously telling you. If you value your life. She's small, but she hurts.
She is fierce.
I just sort of like nudge Eladar on the side as we walk. I'm like, sometimes I wonder who really runs the place.
That would be her.
Yeah, most definitely.
So we're off to the
Yep, you all head down these very elegant hallways. This whole place almost has an undercurrent of magic, but it's not unpleasant. It's a nice, sort of pleasant hum. Like wind whistling through the trees on a summer's day. Or the sort of cool air as you walk down a leaf-filled path in the middle of autumn. It's just very nice. And you all head towards the where the council meeting is taking place. Mad-Eye gets the door open for you all, and you walk in, and it's this huge room. And, Professor, you can already see that most everybody is here, except for your wife. You see everyone's taking their places, sort of turning to you as Mad-Eye sort of nods and goes to take his place, motioning for places where your friends can stand.
Guilty! No, sorry. Greetings, everyone. I know, apparently, my appearance might be quite shocking. That, in fact, I am not dead. I fear that the rumors of my death have been greatly exaggerated. Well, actually, obfuscated by magic. But that is neither here nor there. I come to you with news of the most dire. It appears me and my fellows, they found me in a mirror, by the way. Never been trapped in a mirror before. It was very interesting. Anyway, they found me, and along the way we've sort of stumbled across, well, the Fallen is returning, and we have been fighting his demon lover, whatever, De Moriel, who has been trying to unlock ancient demons. To that end, we have found ourselves thrust about the continent, getting more and more deeper into the mess. So much so that we have acquired Tau Ren. Well, I haven't acquired Tau Ren. We haven't acquired Tau Ren. But my friend Connor here is the king of Tau Ren. In a united Tau Ren that is willing to fight against the Fallen. Even though I really believe that no one believes that this is really happening. We've come here to seek aid and information as we travel north. I thought it best that we stop here so that you all might be aware of the situation. And perhaps you have heard anything. We're desperate for information. We are literally desperate to figure out what is going on and not play catch-up. We need to be ahead of this game, and I'm afraid we are quite behind still.
At this point, Mad-Eye speaks up and goes, well, there are things we do know. Jesus Christ, Charles. Thanks. There is one of the Archmages running around trying to find out information. And then Fioriel, I think.
Oh yes, she's on our side. I have direct communication with Fioria.
At this point, they kind of just sort of sit up and take notice that you are in direct communications with an Archmage of the Arcana.
Do not look at me like that, all of you. Do you understand the situation that I am in?
She's not a matchmaker.
Wilhelmina speaks up at this point. Are you sure you can trust her?
She has literally saved our lives, and she has helped with the help of... I say the paladin's name, who was in charge of all the paladins. We've actually helped seal one of these things. I trust her implicitly and with my life, because she has saved it.
At this point, Victoria Greenbrier speaks up, a very soft-spoken, hands neatly folded in front of her. I know of Fioriel. She is trustworthy, if nothing else, and the rumors are true. She has severed all ties with the Arcana. Which Mad-Eye pops up again, which is currently in turmoil with losing 3 archmages in God knows how many months.
Yes, well, I'm afraid they've done most of that to themselves. Fioriel agrees heavily. Not heavily. Fioriel is sympathetic to our cause.
Tori speaks up. Well, she is helpful, then. That is a good thing. Because it is true, we have heard reports of this darkness coming about. There have been talks of demons haunting places they should not haunt. And other such things, if the rumors in Shah are to be true. Gods, the poor fools. But if this is true, if everything of what you say is true, then I believe we do have to do this.
I'm afraid everything I said is true. We have, without a doubt, darkness is returning to this land, and as it stands now, the world, we don't know how deep they are, but there is no force that could stop if they were to just spring up now. We are fighting a fire that I hope we win, but there are too many fronts, and we need as much help as we can get.
Nefarian speaks up now. Yes, well, I think, provided all of this information and the fact that you are not only allying yourself with the former Archmage of the Arcana, but you are also allied with the now newly crowned King of Telren, that it is obvious that it is dire indeed.
As always, Master, you see things as they are.
So, what shall we do, then, about it? Victoria speaks up. We have considerable knowledge locked away here in the library.
I'm hoping that that is our secret I can't remember the phrase right now. But I'm hoping that that is our secret weapon. I'm hoping knowledge. That what your great-great-grandfather set forth could help us save the world.
As always, knowledge is key and power, and it is a power that our enemy does not have. We shall wield it accordingly. We will consult the library, see what there is, and otherwise we will see about gathering any and all information. We should call in our agents to see whatever they can find. Whatever this is, we will find its weaknesses, we will exploit them, and we will stop this.
I want to make one quick thing. Any agent that has been out for too long, or that has been out for a long time and has not reported back, we should be wary of infiltration. And I mean that of all of us. Can I have insight and check all the people that talked to me? So just because I'm like paranoid.
Yeah, while he's talking, I was going to whisper this to you, and it's right now. While he was talking, I wanted to be scrutinizing everybody's face and seeing anyone who looks like they have a grudge against the professor or like anything like that to make it seem like he is
Okay. So anybody who wants to roll insight, roll a single insight check, because I'm not doing like no, 8 or 9 insight checks back to back.
There's a lot of them.
There's a lot of people here.
I like how we both have the document open, my dear.
Link. I may have been looking at six. Okay.
So was I, because I couldn't remember what I put down.
Oh shit, Talar.
Damn.
I have a plus 10, I only rolled a 9.
I have a plus 5 and I got 22, that's funny.
So, you all sit there and take stock. You all know Mad-Eye, he seems to be a bit grumpy. But that's about it. He also, you get most of these people are on edge. Not only with the subject at hand, but the fact that the professor is back. I mean, from Mad-Eye going... and pointing to the letters when he received them, the missives that you sent, they've kind of known that you were alive, but the fact that you're alive and here and everything's going on has been a bit much. They seem all pretty genuine and shaken up, though you all get kind of a sneaky, kind of slick feeling from Nefarian. There doesn't seem to be any ill intent there, but you look at him and... it's just kind of, you get almost snake oil salesman. But not anything remotely evil, but kind of like, no, I don't want to buy your used car.
That one's a weasel. I don't say that out loud.
Good.
Got him.
He's also the master professor of necromancy.
Necromancy.
Oh, shit. I definitely don't say that out loud then.
That is such a corny thing to say, though.
I ain't got nobody. So, you, they all seem to be genuinely on edge. No one seems to be acting strange or seems a little bit off other than Mr. Snake Oil Salesman.
So with that said, I leave the floor open to any of you or any of my compatriots here. We really, information is the key, and we will be going to the library shortly. But in all of your dealings, I was just wondering if any of you have any insight into this matter. Tori?
Yes?
It's good to see you. I walk up and I give him a hug.
He hugs you back.
Your sister was quite mad when she found out that I was still alive.
Oh, yes. Had to replace a great many of things.
Yes. It's good to see you. You had mentioned Shaw earlier.
Well, yes. They've been asking for aid. They've even come so far as to petition us for any information that we might have that could be useful. The young prince is quite desperate.
Petitioned for what information?
He is desperate. He was hoping that perhaps impartial nature might persuade some of the other city-states here to lend aid to them. There is a growing darkness there, he says. His father has not been the same. The city doors are sealed. He worries for what is to come. And with what you're saying, I fear what it might be.
This is not the first we've heard of shadows in Shah. And I fear that it's far enough out of the way that they may have been gathering there. I'm not sure which countries they have a foothold in, but Shah would be a good one.
There was a bit of an idea that we had that they might have been behind a little bit of what's been going on in the Arcana as well.
Yes, sure, clearing a path to the wastes, as it were.
Yes. They almost, they sort of look amongst each other, and there's varying looks of some are dismayed, others are a little bit disgusted, others seem like expected out of 10, to be honest. It's the Arcana.
The hatred runs deep here.
Bertrand speaks up, and if rumors are to be believed some of the agents down near Shaloon have talked about the dwarves are being quiet as if trying to hide something that's going on there as well. They don't like to give up information. They are stubborn, as always.
Yes, well, we don't like to share all that much, thank you.
In talk times, such ill tidings should be shared freely.
Oh, indeed, sir.
Professor, how much... I whisper this quietly-ish and while we're standing in front of them, like, how much of our plan are we telling them? Like, are we telling them that we're trying to get to Shar with the army?
Yes, I think we should be as honest as we can.
I don't really know how stealthy an army is going to be.
I don't think it's about stealth. When Shar needs our help.
Right, but we're not exactly going to be able to hide the fact that we're bringing an army.
No, well, I believe that I've sent a letter to Mad-Eye stating almost that we have an army coming.
Oh, yeah. Mad-Eye knows what you guys are doing.
Then I request that if there's any chance that they can help us seem legitimate to the other city-states that we are true in our claim here to let the army pass.
Victoria speaks up. We are an organization first and foremost for the collection and preservation of knowledge, sir. We try not to meddle in politics too much. It happens on occasion. But we leave well enough alone so we may be left alone. Yes, however, such times are different.
Is it really politics when it's the whole fate of the entire world?
It is not, which is why we are breaking with tradition. At least if the council agrees. Such times call for desperate measures. And when darkness calls, wizards go to war.
Why does that sound familiar?
I believe you said something of a sort at one point, Velen.
No, perhaps I had. I know that I've read that somewhere.
It is true. There will be no information to protect if it is destroyed. There is no reason to collect information if everything is destroyed. I am not so blind as to not see the writing on the walls, and the writing says that we must stand up and stop this. Whatever information you may find in the library, I will open up even the most ancient and protected of tomes. Anything we can gather, we will use.
Thank you, Victoria. Wilhelmina?
Yes?
Oh, it's so wonderful to see you. Hoping, before we head out, that you might have something interesting for us to take along. I always find your knickknacks useful in dangerous situations.
She kind of gives you this sort of smile, like, yes, my knickknacks. You want new toys, then?
Oh, yes, please.
Is this the, like, fantasy version of Q?
Literally what I put in the notes.
That is literally what I put in the notes. I suppose I have some magical items for you that you may use.
I'm just saying, we're going to save the world, Wilhelmina. It's time to unlock the good stuff.
It's very strange. Someone brought something in recently. It's a very rare item. I have no use for it here. I was going to put it away and take it apart and see what I can learn from it, but I see you have holy people.
Hello!
Hi!
Nice
to
meet
you.
Yes.
There's
one in training over there, too.
Yes, I see you all. Yes, there's a lot of you. Not surprising you're fighting demons. Mm. Shall we go to my office, and I shall unlock the good stuff?
Oh, I think so.
I lean over to Arendir, and I whisper, do you think she's talking about alcohol?
Probably not, but we can only hope.
I send a message to Corin. If you're looking for alcohol,
the one in purple, Bertrand, is the one you're looking for.
Bertrand Wink. Sounds like someone who enjoys their... Anyway.
He does. And Victoria goes, then we know what we must do. Whatever favors you have, call them in. Whatever, we will take stock of our age and see who is responding, make note of who isn't responding, and where they were last known to be. We will
just
not be caught unawares.
Yes.
Pug!
With my wife, God. With my wife out, who's managing the wards?
Tori wiggles his fingers.
Oh.
I know how she does her work. I'm familiar with it, though. I admit I do not have the predilection and aptitude she does for them. I will do my best until she arrives. But I have been in constant contact with her as well, making sure that she is alive and well and untouched.
Good. I may have a message for you to send to her later.
Of course.
I appreciate the trouble that this might be, and I know that I haven't been here in a while, but it is good to see all of you alive and healthy. And I'm...
And I smile now.
I'm glad this place is still standing, that's all I have to say.
As are we. And Victoria will actually come up and clasp your hands in hers and squeeze them.
Thank you, Victoria. I feel I deign to think that your family's legacy might actually be play a big part in this.
It is why this was done in the first place. Certain knowledge will not be erased. Knowledge cannot be lost for a reason. That may have been precipitated by such things, other things, but if we have any information, we will find it. I am sure our stalwart librarian will find it.
That or die in the process to find it.
Knowing her, yes, but doesn't please, sleep. I will call in favors. We will see to the agents. We will make a list.
Just be careful of anyone coming in and out. I worry.
We've doubled the guard, and the wards, and detection.
Good. Then I'll pop over to Wilhelmina's, and then we'll head down to the library.
If you need me, you know where I'll be.
Thank you, Victoria.
She squeezes your hands and nods to you all, and they file out. And,
Oh, wait, I was going to ask a question before we all dismiss.
Yes?
Sorry. You forgive me, Masters, before you mention agents around Shaolun, what news of Shaolun? There's unrest in Mythagar. What's happening in Elven system?
Mad-Eye actually speaks up. I've had agents sent down there. Shaolun is, of course, a sister to us in a lot of ways. We would not see them abandoned all the way over there on the other side of the mountain, surrounded by the Empire. But they are on alert. King Elishor has made sure that they are proper and ready for whatever will come, but the agents I've talked to have said that the dwarves have mostly... Well, they have been quiet. There was talk of the moot did not go as planned.
But why is Wilhelmina here? Should she have not been at the moot?
She went for a day or two and then said she had to come back for work. She has a lot of projects on hand, and apparently she got into a fight and she left in a huff.
That does not surprise me.
You know how she gets. She's glad she came back, but she mentioned that it was the air about the moot was different from most years past. I think she said some other things.
We'll ask
but
her.
But I was trying to avoid your wife at the time.
Oh, well,
Understandable. Perhaps we can ask her. We have a dwarf here. Perhaps they could, she could persuade Wilhelmina's cold, stony heart. I'm glad she's not here to hear me say that.
No, she's currently off talking with Bertrand at the moment before heading over. Mad-Eye nods and goes, I'll be in my office and talking to your father, apparently, so... Good luck.
Yes.
And when you get to the library, don't touch anything.
See, I told you.
And he'll leave. At which point, Wilhelmina stomps up. She is... there's a fire to her. She is a bearded dwarf lady. Keen intelligence in her eyes. Her hair swept back, pulled in a tight braid. Her beard is also braided with some beads in there as well. She goes, all right, come. I'll show you what I got. She leads you down to her office, in which she kind of gets to her door and she just sort of hits it and it kind of opens. She kind of goes in and it's very different from the professor's office. There's not a square inch in this place that isn't covered in blueprints and, you know, sort of ore and all the sorts of other things. And there are items all over the place, and it's very, this is the mind of some, you can clearly see this is the mind of someone who spends almost all of their time making stuff, cataloging stuff, and figuring out how stuff works. She sighs and she goes over to what looks to be a sort of bookcase, and it looks kind of, things are kind of hanging off, and she brushes it off and she hits a button. And it slides open, revealing another room beyond. She goes, all right, I'll show you the good stuff.
Mina, every time I come into this room, Mina, it's always different. I mean, it's still a bloody mess. If Kristana has seen this, she would have a heart attack.
It's also been 100 years, Professor.
No, but, like, seriously, literally everything is different when you come in here every day. Like, what's this... Mina?
I get bored. Oh. I don't like... change is good! There's nothing wrong with change.
Sure.
I like
keeps
to keep...
the blood pumping.
I mean, my place is not the neatest, but I know where everything is.
And this is why Kristana is not allowed in here.
If she died...
I caught her trying to sneak in. Oh, she would. She'd drop down dead, and then I'd have a deaf halfling in the middle of my workshop.
She'd want to catalog everything. And put labels
she
on
would.
It.
It's exactly organized as to my thought process. She moves it, and then I can't remember what I was doing with it.
Yeah, should come, I put come, this back down exactly where I found it, then?
I would appreciate it.
I think it looked
and
like that.
She,
I like her already.
She leads all of you. And as so much of the wizard stuff you have ever run into in your time adventuring, the inside is much bigger than the outside. And it is... This place is neat. It is clean. Everything is in its proper place, and it is a collection of amazing sets of magical items, including what seems to be in back a... glass square with runes and sigils engraved upon the glass. Professor, and I think Rael's the only other one who's trained in Arcana. If you can roll Arcana for me.
I most certainly can. I am so excited.
I was going to peer at it and see if it looks similar to what we got when we were teleported that one time. Is my freaking... It's really that high. Good lord. Well, thank God. 17. I rolled 7.
You guys take a look, and even from there, you're like, oh, someone is warding the fuck out of that. That is a do not touch under penalty of you losing both your arms at the same time, painfully.
I should probably not go and touch that.
Just literally going to put my hands behind me, put them together, and just clasp them so that I don't touch anything.
Yeah, don't recommend you touch that one.
Mina,
I have
those wards.
I got a hold of something.
Professor Cox's head. Like, good lord, Mina. Do you know what that would do to a person?
That's why it's on there. Do you know what's under there?
Do you know... Who's going to clean that up?
If someone touches a hold of that, it won't matter what's to clean up.
What have you got in there, Mina?
Oh, you're just making me want to touch it now.
You don't want to touch it. You don't
no,
want to...
No, I'm sure I don't.
It's... You see, I got it. And I really should have gotten rid of it. But it's so interesting, and I wanted to study it, but I'm afraid to.
Oh, Mina, enough foreplay. Open it.
I'm not opening it. It is a deck of many things.
Nope, oh, do not open it. Nope.
Okay, so the dumb person...
My apprentice opened it.
Good
Lord. Do you notice I don't have an apprentice anymore?
What happened to him?
There's a reason there are wards somewhere now.
Mina, why didn't you destroy it? Mina,
we are missing an apprentice. Do you really want me to try to get rid of it? It is unbelievable.
Who the hell brought you that?
My apprentice! The fool!
Well, now we can't ask him where he got it.
I wish I knew so I could send it back. I have been tempted highly to pull a card.
Do not pull a card, Mina. That thing will ruin the world.
Everything I've heard of those is not...
Of course, save it.
Does not end up well.
Yeah, I as soon as you told me she was magical Q, I rolled to see what kind of magical goodies she had.
Do you have anything that won't kill us all, Mina?
Actually, I do. I have something that I think will benefit either the paladin or the cleric. It's not really helpful for on the go, but if you have sort of a place that you could set this down, it should be, you know what, here. And she goes and she walks over to what seems to be sort of a pillar, and on top is this most beautiful ornate basin, and she goes, I think it's called a basin of angels. If you install this in a temple, it sort of basically sort of goes, all ye who are evil here, you can't sort of come in and go fuck off.
Can I roll a religion check to see if I know anything about it?
Anybody trained in religion can roll.
17!
Question.
I only have a +3 to religion.
Do I get trained in skills from the classes I multiclassed in, or no?
Nope.
Okay.
Mm-mm. All right. Neither.
I wasn't sure, so I wanted to double check, because I didn't.
So, yeah, that would be a little OP.
Right.
Up.
Hold on. Basin of the Angel. So you all have, both of you have heard of it. You know, it is kind of a powerful, magical, and holy artifact. And in game terms, if you install this in a temple, essentially what happens is that any good aligned creatures within 30 feet of the basin gain advantage on all saving throws. If you drink from the basin, you get 3d10 hit points back, and it removes one condition. You can't bottle it, though. And while the basin is installed, it radiates protection from good and evil, which protects against fiends and undead. And all evil creatures who see it make a DC 15 saving throw or be frightened. And any evil being that touches the basin takes 3d10 radiant damage and is then teleported 3 miles away.
What?
Violation of the temple being truly great danger, as then facing a great enemy, a solar will appear. To defend the temple.
We need to put that in the Dawnwood.
Oh, am I really Robo?
Yeah, you're a little Robo-y.
Oh,
no,
hell, the Robo.
We've been able to understand you, but yeah, you're Robo.
Oh my god.
Okay, so am I Robo?
No.
No, you're fine.
Okay,
you were fine.
Right. Oh, hey, Talmart. I forgot to ask. Do you have an extra holy symbol by chance? Otherwise, we'll have to see if we can pick one up.
I have not, one, but it's not for Muhammad, so sorry.
A crude one, at least.
Or we can swing by some place that has a temple or something.
Carve this stick into an image of your god.
And I was going to say, we have a shield in the bag of holding. Anyone good with smith tools?
I mean, I could forge one, I suppose.
Well, if we take this basin back to the Dawnwood...
I mean, yeah, Connor and I are both good with smith's tools, so...
Yeah, you can tell me what you want. I can put a illusion on there, and Connor, you can work it in.
Or I could make my own bloody one.
She meant, like, put a template down.
Yeah. It's more...
Yeah, but she said Connor to build
your own. It was very difficult, and it took me a lot of tries, but I did
take
my own.
I mean, I'll take the template, that'd be lovely. Oh,
I'm imagining this wonderful little short story of poorly baked cookies for Talmar.
You're like, it's you have to make your own. It's a holy symbol, not a fucking lightsaber.
It is not.
I just picture him, like, sitting there, like, trying to make it, and he comes out with, like, a three-winged dragon. No, it doesn't look... And, like... trying to make Bahamut.
You have no idea how long it took me to build that thing, Professor.
It's made out of macaroni and glitter.
I made this for my god.
It's a hand dragon.
Mike, take the inspiration.
Damn it, man.
Oh, man.
That's fine.
So she looks at you, and she looks. Apparently I'm not Robo, right?
No,
you're good.
Good.
The Sacred Overlord has left for a while.
It has been sated. Yes. So, essentially, she goes, "I can't do anything with it. It is holy."
Since I just recognize what it is, I will step up front to her, and I will say, "I would gladly take this to my home temple."
Yes, that's exactly what I was thinking, actually, Corin.
This would be a lot of food to a lot of people.
Yep.
Don't take it, smart.
Holy shit! I take it!
Well, hey, we'll
meet up. And you teleported 3 miles from where?
Oh my god, how are you?
What a twist.
Takes all this
reading. We're the beast. All of a sudden, you're like, oh no, not M. Shama Lama Lama Ding Dong. No! You get the fuck out of here!
The angels are mad about you.
The angels are weeping.
Talmar is silently judging you.
Guys, alright, here's a really good question. What would happen if I would hit someone in the head with the basin?
Why would you want to do that?
Like, what if they were evil? Would they take 3d10 from force damage?
It has to be installed before the power.
It has to be installed before it works.
Oh, that would be awesome.
You gotta call a holy plumber so that he can hook it up to the holy.
I think Gamma knows how to do that.
Probably.
Part of Paladin training.
Typically, you know, there's an order that does that.
You don't want to step on their toes. Anyway.
Yeah, but...
I'm glad you all have a place for this. I don't want it to go to waste. It's just been sitting here. I've been thinking about... kinda...
This artifact's been missing for thousands of years. What? Where did you get it?
I can't remember where I got that from. I picked it up on my travels. I saw it on the side of the road.
The Greenbrier Collective is literally like Antiques Roadshow, basically.
Yeah.
I found it in some person's head. For it.
We have everything.
There's everything here. And she goes, I have more stuff. There's some stuff I would not, unfortunately, I love you all to bits. Well, okay, lies. I love him, and she'll point to the professor. I love him to bits.
Aww.
I don't do that. Fucking A, my sister's kids do that all the time. But I'm not giving them a fucking sword of sharpness. Fucking no better.
Yeah, I know what that's like. I'm gonna pull out the 2 pounds of crystal that I still haven't really gotten proper answers about. Would this be useful for you at all?
Mina, there's an interesting story behind that.
Yeah, it is actually pretty interesting.
Kaladin and I, that's the dwarf, we were teleported to Ophelia into a tower of the glorious empire.
Was that the name? I always forget.
Found a whole cavern full of those. I have 10 pounds in my bag. Which can't help.
Oh, I forgot you took so much.
I rolled a nat 20, I think.
She'll look at the ones that Kel is offering up and goes, oh, and they are so beautiful. Oh, you can use these to make things. Oh, the things you can make with these things. Oh, so, like, they've got really great restorative properties and whatnot, but you can also fine-tune them to do all sorts of radiant work. It is amazing. I love these things. Othul is loath to get rid of them because, oh, they're so deep. You have to mine so deep. You normally can't get these.
Well, we got 12 pounds worth, so... Yeah.
Mina, I think we'll leave you to it for now?
How many pounds?
Well, I'm giving you my 2, because I have no use for them.
How many pounds total?
I'll give you a pound, Mina.
So 3 pounds total.
3 pounds? She will give you 1,500 gold pieces.
Sweet. Where are my pencils?
I expect to see some of those returned fancy, Mina.
Put that in the bag of holding if you want, just to both of you and the professor's gems.
Oh, she's like in heaven. She's like, well, if you need, well, there's more items in here. There's a couple I could stand to let go.
Like,
do you have any weapons of any kind that, or armor perhaps?
I think you've got enough of those, Kelly.
Okay. You are not one to talk.
Look, I just like alcohol.
And I just
I also like alcohol.
Maybe she has some magic alcohol, you don't know.
That's true.
Do you?
I'm sorry, are you asking if I have alcohol?
The professor is just like,
do I look like I have alcohol?
Don't call her
yes.
Mina.
Of course I have alcohol, please.
Yes. She's a dwarf.
That's what I thought.
You
said it, no.
I don't have much in the way of weapons and armor. They bore me. But I do have other things.
As a fellow lady, what do you have that you think I would like from the general appearance that you see here?
Weapons and armor, mostly. You look like a walking armory, dear.
Well, okay, I only have 3 on right now. What is everybody
only
on?
Only 3?
Yes!
And that's bigger than you are.
I like you a lot.
Shut your face, Telmer.
Well, let's see, what do I have? I do have this... It's really dumb, alright? I made it for my niece, she didn't want it. So I brought it back, and it's been sitting in here ever since.
She didn't want your gift. What a rotten child.
She brings out what looks to be a teddy bear backpack, and it's a handicapper sack. I love you, Charles. I'm gonna get it next week. I'm okay with this. Well, I rolled handy haversack.
You couldn't not do it.
I know. I actually think I have something, I think, and I don't want to stereotype Your Majesty, but I think you might like this one. And she goes and she grabs what looks to be a horn.
Shit.
And and it is indeed a brass horn of Valhalla.
Yes!
And she goes, I got this about 50 years ago from, what's her name? Blonde, badass, Talrenian woman. She's currently ahead of a clan.
Tess.
Her mother gave it to me when I went down to visit Well, I was not going down to visit her. I was, you know what I mean. And she gave it as a peace, sort of peace offer. She said, here, take this. And I'm like, oh, awesome. And it sat in my shop for ever since. And I'm like, I could take it apart and learn what the magic's over, but it's so pretty. So take it. It might be of use to you. And I think I have an immovable rod. I don't think anybody needs that.
Oh, please, can I have that, please, Mina?
She'll hand it over. I'd be careful. I know someone who stuffed it in their pants.
Oh, Jesus.
I've cleaned it, but they stuffed it in their pants.
Wait, what?
It's really dumb. It's I think a drow. A drow did it.
Oh, Lord.
Just trying to make some kind of homage joke.
Right. I'm just going to put this here. Thank you, Mina.
It's cleaned. I cleaned it.
Yes,
I... You don't think I'd handle a rod without proper taking care of it beforehand?
Don't watch what you say around these people, Mina, and the way you say it.
Oh, no, she's dwarvish. She knows what she's talking about.
I'm afraid I know all too well. Mina, this has been wonderful. I hope the crystals come in handy. Perhaps you will show me before we leave what you... could make out of some of them. I'm going to see Kristona.
Oh, God, have mercy on your soul.
Yes. Rael, are you okay?
I got some fireball beads.
What?
I'm fine.
I got two.
She's fine. I'm not. Let's
go to Link! She smiles and goes, when you're done with Kristana, if you want to come back for drinks.
That sounds lovely.
Yes, invite Bertrand. It'll be a party. Right, everyone, to the library?
Yes.
Yeah.
Sure. Oh, okay. Oh. The professor, like, straightens all his robes. Is on his way, and he like gets to the library doors, and I'm just sort of like,
"What's up, Professor? What do you have?"
I haven't seen her in 100 years. Oh, crap!
What?
I run back to Wilhelmina really quick.
We'll wait here, I guess.
Back to soon.
I take out some of my gold. Could you do your thing? Could you make this look like a dragon?
Hold on a minute. And
she hasn't seen me in 100 years. I'm not going in there without a present.
She sort of turns it so it looks like an ancient gold dragon.
Thank you, Mina. You're a lifesaver, quite literally, as I run back down the hall.
That's all right. You owe me a drink sometime.
I'll play you later tonight!
And
I come back.
Back.
Sorry, everyone. When you meet the devil, always bring a gift. I push open the doors.
You push open the doors, and the library. The library. It is amazing.
I take a deep breath, because it's been 100 years.
And it smells like vanilla. The smell of old paper. And walls and walls of scrolls and tomes, and it raises up in levels, and you can see it also goes down as well. Above you, painted in beautiful colors, are murals of the exploits of those of the Greenbrier Collective, of the stories of the knowledge contained within. There are fairy lights trapped in glass all around, shedding beautiful, crisp light without ever endangering any of the paper in here. And it is beautiful. Your feet echo off the marble flooring as you walk. There is a massive, massive desk that meets you in the very beginning. And it is covered in books, but also dragon figurines. Nothing but dragon figurines in different sizes and different colors. There's even what seems to be a miniature dragon skull sitting right in the middle as you greet Sue. And as you walk in, you see holding books you swear are twice her height, this halfling woman. And she puts the books down, looks at you over her glasses, and she is drop-dead gorgeous. With a fierce, intelligent look on her face, a wry smile. Hello, yes, Kristana Evanshield. Have you met my skull?
Kristana, it's good to see you.
She crosses her arms as she looks at you, Professor, looking up at you. Hello, yes, it has been a while. You've been gone for quite some time. They said you were dead.
Not dead. Still alive. I'm hoping that you could help us. We need to look through everything. And I pull out...
Everything.
And I put out... I pull out the dragon. Yes, everything. Look. I will tell you the story of how I met an ancient gold dragon.
She... There's this look in her eyes, and Professor, you all have seen kind of like this glint of the eyes. It's the glint of sort of the dragon lust of the my horde. And she looks at you, goes, "You met a gold dragon?"
Oh, yes, he was very grumpy.
He's an ancient gold dragon, of course he's grumpy.
Well, yes.
I apologize. Side note, I'm sorry, Kristana. I am doing a poor facsimile. You can kick my ass later. Lord knows you will.
But Kristana, look, you're right there.
She takes the statue from it, eyes it. Do you look like this?
Sort of. Mina tried to help me make it look like him.
It was a bit bigger than that.
Of course, it was a bit bigger than
she looks at you as if you are dumb as hell.
I'm grinning. Because I love playing up the idiot in front of the professor and his friends.
And.
Don't get the stern talking to.
You keep very interesting company, Professor, and she finds a nice place for it. Ata, so. You need information. Mad-Eye said that you might be down here looking for something and that you were to be given access to everything. Which, you will be very careful, because there are ancient books here, and you will observe proper rules on handling these tomes and these scrolls, and everything will go back in their proper places when you are done. However,
yes, Kristana.
I have been told that they might be concerning a dragon. Mad-Eye, again. Him and his sight.
Yes.
Singular.
It comes in handy. Did you have to emphasize the singular?
He said something about maybe a dragon in the Shadowfell. So naturally, I started looking and I started pulling up all sorts of books on this thing. The Shadowed One, the King of Darkness, and a dragon of great age. Unsurpassed in any age. Tales are very disconcerting.
Please tell us all you know.
He was sealed by the Dawn's Graces. That's what they were calling themselves. After it took a lot of effort. It seemed a lot of lives were required to seal him. A whole city full of lives cost to seal him up. Whoa. He was not. The tales of what he did, his wings would darken the sky. His breath would take out entire villages in a single blast. This thing is terrifying. He was used, supposedly, as a mount. The only time he ever bent the knee.
For the fallen?
Yes.
Well, that wonderful news.
She taps. It looks to be a fairly ancient book, and she mentions it's a copy of a copy of a copy. She can't tell you exactly if, you know, the information there is 100%, as in over the ages and various copying, sometimes people like to tinker with what's written down. And she looks displeased as fuck at even having to say that. But there are other accounts seem to counter this. No, well, not counter this, sort of bolster this. And she goes, if this talk of darkness is true and whatnot, then this is troubling. If this dragon is out, it would take another city of people sacrificing themselves to steal him again.
Can he get killed?
Do we have any idea where he's sealed?
Fioriel knows.
She's looking for him.
Didn't she find a portal to the shadow, though?
I thought she was looking for a part of the channel.
She was looking. She heard rumors of two that might be big enough to serve it. And she'll tap the book again. What other information I have has said that it was not able to be killed by any means. I was trying to find more about the Dawn's Graces. Because surely if they took on this great darkness, the fact that they couldn't kill a dragon is worrisome.
Well, if you wouldn't mind looking up anything that references the Cloak of the Dread Beast, because that is a name of one of the Dawn's Graces.
Do you have any other names I should cross-reference while I work?
I sort of just look around, because we have a few of them that we have descriptions, physical, the shield there.
Show her my shield.
The mace.
I say, basically tell her what it is in your comic.
And she looks and takes notes. Alright, I will go.
Since I know that they aren't normally named, this might help us.
Please, Professor. We have gotten a lot of information since you've been gone. Well, I have been gathering a lot of information.
Of course, Rosanna.
So
you are
marvel
at what you do.
I like the little sniff that you did at the end of that snicket.
Blink! And she says it.
Yeah.
As she does it.
Stupid.
She's gonna kick my ass and I'm gonna love every fucking second of it.
She knows she does it.
Oh no, she's gonna kick my ass on Friday, which is fine. I deserve it.
So all DMing for your friends is giving it to each other all the time.
Yep. So she goes and she takes notes on everything that you guys have. He goes, I will see if I can find any information at all. Feel free to peruse. Make sure your hands are clean. Do not bend any pages, and you put them right back where you found them.
I know the drill, Rosanna.
I know you do, but they don't.
That's what they've been
told. She gives you a stern look, and then on little halfling legs goes, and she goes down the stairs.
Whoa.
Yes.
The city was sacrificed. I happen to know the name.
The name of the city is not mentioned.
I think we know what city it was, though. It must have been the Hollow.
But we spoke with that mage in Shaolun who was there, and he didn't mention a dragon large enough to block out the sun.
Right, but they needed a city to seal him, a city to die, right?
I mean, I agree that it's probably the Hollow, but I don't know. Well, granted, he was...
Wasn't the Hollow attacked long after the... long after the Fallen attack was. The Hollow there... happened like 200, 300 years ago, if I remember correctly.
Oh.
Yeah.
Isn't there a missing elven city?
There is a missing elven city. One that's considered myth.
O-M-G.
God damn it.
Okay. Wonderful.
Sorry.
O-M-P.
What was I going to look for? Lord. I was going to look for something.
You have been given access to the entire library.
I find a comfy chair to sleep in.
As proper for a father, you immediately go to sleep as soon as you hit the chair.
I think I might do the same, to be honest.
I'm going to be looking for blueprints, schematics of the keep in, like any the palace in Shark.
Or anything that'll help us by getting the car.
Awesome. Okay, roll investigation for me.
Those mountain passes are probably our best bet.
Investigation is plus 2. That's 18.
After searching, you slowly start to find there's a method to the madness here, and you quickly find where you can find information about Shar, and after a minute or two of perusing, you do indeed find old schematics of the palace in Shar. These are the blueprints of when it was first built. And okay. As you're looking in the very back, there seems to be the additions and whatnot. High or low, Charles?
Well, this group's always high. Let's go high.
That's an 85.
Oh, shit.
You're looking. You're looking, and in the back, you find that a sort of old schematic. It predates the one in the front. And there is a mark. What seems to be the bottom level of the keep, there is a mark. And there is a scratch on there. And it takes a moment of reading, but you can kind of make it out that there's a word in common there, and it is a black square in the center of what seems to be the lowest part of the dungeon.
Secret door.
Secret tunnel.
That's fucking cool as shit. Whoa, they do collect a lot of information. Holy fuck.
Jilly, you find... You're looking for your college, yes? Or are you looking for agents for the Greenbrier? There really isn't any in here. This is more of the information that everybody collects. If you're looking for a roster like that, your best bet would be talk to one of the archmages. This is one of the keepers. Wrong group. You might want to talk to, say, Mad-Eye or Victoria. At least that's the feeling you get. Professor, you're looking for ancient travelogues for portals. You find some, not a lot. It seems to be mostly not kept in here. But you do... There does seem to be a list. And that's mostly kept up front where Kristana has been keeping it. Sort of a log of all the portals that, you know, the Greenbrier runs and whatnot. And some other things. It's going to take you a while to go through it, but you can. So you guys peruse, and about half an hour later,
yes,
She comes back up carrying books again. All right, I think I found things. oddly enough, there is something very ancient in the back, and she puts the books down. It is under magical sort of seals to keep it from breaking apart. It's that old. And from if I know, sorry, multitasking is not my strong suit at the moment.
You're good.
She goes, I can take you down to it. The supposed age on this dates to mid-Glorious Empire.
Well, that might prove quite useful.
Come on, come on.
Boop, boop, boop.
You all head downstairs, and it's down and down and down and down. Oh my god, people keep distracting me. You get to the bottom, and this is where most of the old texts are. They're behind glass, they're behind wards, there's magic that's keeping the... I love you too, Charles.
I knew that is exactly what you were doing when she said that. Like, you're gonna be an ass.
It's done with love.
I like how we all just inundate you with whispers.
I was gonna type distracting whisper.
That was like Caleb over here.
It's okay, Kyle actually walked in front of me and I got distracted. I'm like, what are you? Okay.
You had to stop and look at that booty.
Yeah.
Always. I fail every time. I can't help it. It's big and round and in my face. Oh, if I go down and take you all with me.
That sounds fun.
So about these magical books.
Yes, about this magical book.
Oh, shit. There's a whole bunch of them. She leads them back. And it's a torn, old scroll that's been completely rolled out and held into place, and it's in almost this bubble, and you can't touch it. And she looks and she's like, there's amplifying spells on this so you can read it. I decided to come down here. I thought I saw something. You said the cloak of the dread beast.
Yes, that's what I'm wearing.
And she goes and she starts reading from it, and it talks about a mace of 1,000 sacrifices, a shield of divine light, a bow of the elements, a cloak of the dread beasts, the leathers of the purple prince, and then there is the great axe of passing time. And then there is the hands of the weapon. And these are considered the Dawn's Graces. And it says they were wielded by people sent forth by the gods themselves to cast down the fallen once more and to save this land from its evil. And it said that after they were done, they had their weapons set aside. For it was said even then that someday the darkness would rise again, and when that happens, they would return, they would gather their weapons, they would lead an army once more, and they would cast him down. Prophecy and stories, mostly, but you know how that goes.
Stories are true.
Yes, I never trust prophecy, though. Too many ways it can go wrong or right. Too open to interpretation.
Unreliable narrators, whatnot. but it seems to match what you said.
Well, good. At least we know we have the weapons to deal with the darkness. We just need to find the darkness. And stop it. Hopefully before it comes to this world.
That is preferable.
Yes.
Is there ways to seal portals to the Shadowfell? Something we can do?
Sealing would be wards. Ward magic. And she starts almost going through a catalog in her head as she sort of just makes motions and goes, I think I could find something. Your better bet would be to talk to the ward master.
We don't have her at the moment, but we can get in contact with her.
If she could go to wherever you need warding, that would be even better.
Yes. That would.
But if you're going in hopes of sealing this dragon, I fear what the cost might be.
I don't think I'm prepared to make that sort of decision.
I don't think any of us are.
Is anybody ever prepared for what sacrifices are needed?
This is war.
Casualties
will happen.
I want to do as much as we can to avoid killing civilians as much as possible.
We'll figure something out.
I would just prefer that it just not be released.
Did this dragon have a name, by any chance?
We already know the name, actually.
Do we know the name?
I thought we did.
Yes.
Cool. I want to put it in my notes.
Oh, I have it.
Is it Shadow Tooth or something?
No, it starts with a T.
Tinnithon.
Tinnanathon.
Tinnitus?
Tinnanathon.
And he was the King of Shadow or the King of Darkness?
He was the Shadow Lord, the King of Shadow. Supposedly a Shadow Dragon. If it's in the Shadowfell, that's the reason.
Alright, it's in my notes now.
If it's anything like the notes say, he is nigh unstoppable.
Fuck.
However, those are, of course, stories handed down from some, 2,000 years? At least. Might be embellished. Stories of survivors terrified for what they saw. Who knows?
Fear we won't know till we're face to face. Hopefully that doesn't happen.
Face to snout, really.
Jolie, you are super quiet again. Is there anything else you need?
I think that will do for now, Kristana.
A way to stop time, slow it down so we can get to places that we need to go faster. So many places we have to go, you guys.
Well, there's a spell that you could use to make things happen. It's not recommended, but there's a spell. I doubt you know how to cast the wish spell.
No.
I don't even know what that
is. Spell
is doesn't solve all of our problems.
That spell is too tricky. It worked out for me once, though.
And I'm glad it did, Professor.
Yes, but that's apparently where everyone thought I died. I saved the day there. Heremiah is safe.
She'll actually come up and give you a hug.
Thank you, my darling.
If you need anything else, I'm going to continue to go through and see if I can find anything on this fallen one, this dragon, and anything else.
Could you look for Demoriel as well? Apparently,
I can do that.
His paramour.
Also,
and second in command.
His generals.
I will do so then.
Oh, one of their names was Auriel.
Yeah, we already killed him, so.
Theoretically.
Well, I mean, he exploded. I don't think
it'd
be a
problem.
Well, you sealed him, right? In theory.
He's sealed. His items are sealed, which I thought was the reason that he was coming back.
Yes, well, demons live on another plane. Or from another plane, I think.
Yes.
A lot of them you have to kill there.
A lot.
I think we don't.
So we must focus on the more imminent threats.
How long are you going to stay here?
We can't afford to stay too long, but we will spend a couple nights here to gather our options.
Then I will work quick. If you excuse me, then I must go research.
Yes, I don't know.
Also, perhaps anything on Vianoth, supposedly south of the wastes, where the Fallen's buried at.
I will do that as well.
I'll be
here in the library if you need anything.
I don't know about you, but I'm hungry. I think it's time to pay.
I could eat a whole boar.
Well, you're in luck because, well, we don't really hunt here, but Khazrog does conjure up some good meals.
Yes, it's better than I can get you some bread and water.
I can always imagine like tasting like conjure foods, like replicator food. It's like resequenced molecules.
Yeah.
As long as those molecules are in the right combination, it tastes good. I don't care.
Alright. So, rather than roleplay out the next couple days, because that could take the next 200
nope,
million years.
That's fine.
Is there anything you want to do? I know Ryle wants to look up the roster. You want to look up to see what your dad's been doing.
Yeah, I
want
to like talk to him and all that stuff, so that's all set up. Yeah, off camera.
Okay. I didn't quite catch what you said.
I said also when I talked to him, asking him how he's been able to kind of catch up, so like, you know, I'm off camera.
Yeah, we'll take care of that. You live with me. You got
all time.
I like
the sound of that.
Off camera, sudden dad action.
Oh,
No.
Oh, God. Damn it.
Amazing.
That made it on the thing.
I blame the NyQuil.
Perfect.
I love it.
Oh, I didn't show. As we're walking out of the library, I bring out Mirai, and I'm like, would you mind keeping that tiny little halfling company?
I can do that, Professor. And
I go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh my god! There's a swing of epic magnitude. Asha goes, tiny furry dragon in here! Hi! And it's so epic and sweetful.
To war!
Yeah. So, you all, Ryel, you looking through the rosters, you find a familiar name, one that there's a pang in your heart seeing. And you find he's still active and out in the field.
Does it happen to say about where?
Shar.
That's good to know.
It says he's currently there. He's been reassigned there for the last 5 months. There is supposedly an ancient store of books and scrolls that were found. He was out to go either collect them or make copies of them. He recently reported in more than 2 or 3 days before you guys came in. Talmar, you and your father reconnect, and he looks at you, and he goes, Medai wants me to go back. He wants me to help collect information, knowledge, anything that can be used to help you and your friends defeat this.
We can use you.
I will do what I can, but before I go, you need this more than I need this, and this has been passed down from father to son for generations, and this is supposed to go to you, and I hope and pray to the gods that our paths will cross again, but you are always on the move, and I will try to keep in contact, but because I can't be there, this will be here for you to protect you, because I can't. And he hands you a blade.
I take it like very respectfully. I examine it.
He says its name is the Moonlight Blade. Check your journal.
It's a motherfucking heirloom!
Oh, wow. Oh, that's good.
I don't know what's happening over there.
I'm pretty sure nobody wants to know what's happening over there.
Excuse the fuck out of me.
I'm sorry, did you need a moment?
Whoa, holy balls.
Plus two long sword.
That's hot. I like that. I want that in my hands. Well, not Professor Sense, he doesn't like swords.
I'm gonna kind of like unsheath it then and kind of like examine like the blade.
As you look on the blade, in Elvish script is the name of every single person who's wielded this blade since it was forged. And towards the very end, you see your father's name. You see your name.
Oh shit!
Pull my dad into
He hugs you back. Protect them.
I'll make you proud.
I've always been proud of you. And he pulls you in for a hug and holds you tight. I have to go. But go kill some demons for me, would you?
That's what I've been doing.
He'll give you one last hug and says, your mother would have been so proud of you.
Just kind of nod.
Pats you on the cheek. Go join your friends. And he heads off. About the second day of you guys staying here, Professor, you hear a familiar voice come from your bag. Professor.
Hello?
It's Furiel.
Furiel.
I found it.
Are you alright?
A little bit worse for wear. But yes, I'm fine. I found it. Ilalina.
It's in Ilalina. You found Ilalina?
I found Ilalina.
Is it intact?
It's like nothing I've ever seen before. An entire castle, entire city. And it looks like people just disappeared one day.
Yes, I may know what happened to them.
And there's darkness here. It is powerful. And I do not know if I have the strength to take this on by myself. I have called for help. It is coming to me, but I might need you all to come here and help me.
I'm pretty sure we will come.
I know you are looking for other things, but...
A giant dragon from the Shadowfell, Fiora, no, really, please. Top priority. Please give me directions. I will tell the others.
She goes, it's a little bit southeast of Val and Daryl. Nestled in the mountains. To the south there is a cave. It is unremarkable, except for there's an old passageway. I've cleared it out of its denizens. So you will not be harried on your way here. If you follow it, it'll lead you out to here. I'll be waiting here for you.
Excellent. Stay safe, Fury.
And you as well. And it goes dead.
I go find the others and tell them that she has found the city that sacrificed itself, I believe, for evil dark dragon.
How long will it take us to get there? We should leave now.
Well, I can teleport us to Valandero proper, and we can just head southeast from there.
Right. I forgot we have that new ability.
Yes, well, I just know Greenbriar and my home is all.
Maybe we can get one of those thingies in the Dawnwood.
It would take a long time, unless they already have one.
Nope, but we can build one.
Yes, we'll take about a...
year.
Yes.
You guys Shit. Are talking when... Here, Professor!
Mirai!
Kristana has found some things for you!
It looks like it's a day of information, everyone. Kristana has found something.
She... You look at her, sorry. And there is a little bit of glistening around her snout, as if... Whoa!
That's a nice first roll.
That's your first roll, dude.
You blew it.
As if someone's been feeding her bacon.
Mirai?
Yes?
Smudge it off of her snout. Where's Kristana?
Yes. She's down at the library.
Everyone, you're getting so pudgy.
Don't call me fat.
I said pudgy, I did not say fat.
I'm delicately rounded.
Yes. Fey creatures. So worried about your appearance. Down we go to the library.
Da-da-da-da, running all over the place. So you head down, and Astana is already there. Furiously writing in what seems to be a brand new journal. And as you come in, she goes, just in time. And she's sort of waving the ink to dry it real quick. Like, come on. And then, good. She snaps it shut and hands it to you.
What's this?
It's all the information that I have found down in the more ancient records and whatnot. It is everything I have found on the dragon, on the general, on Demoriel. It might take you a little bit to go through, but you'll have the information.
You are a wonder of this world, Kristana, and I value every minute that I've known you.
And I, you, Professor.
I thank you for this. I fear we may be heading out rather soon. So until the next time I see you.
The next time I see you as well.
I won't be 100 years this time.
Please don't. I will have to send someone after you this time.
We have some teleporting to do.
That you do. Before you go, Mad-Eye stops you. Do you want a bio break?
I have to pee.
Okay, a little bit of bio break. We're probably not going to go for too much longer.
I didn't think so.
I'm just a little bit more set up before next week, which is unfortunate.
Yes.
But, yeah, bio break, and then we'll wrap things up.
Okay.
Yep.
So, whenever we're ready? Awesome. So, you guys get stopped before you go. Mad-Eye hands something to you, Professor. Tori. Says it's from your wife.
Oh. I read it.
Open the note. And it's talking, it's in Tori's handwriting. It's talking with Allie.
No!
She said, oops.
Sorry. She literally got up on the table and tried to steal my biscuit.
There's no biscuit stealing.
Hey! Jesus fucking Christ!
So, she sends her love. She thinks she might have a lead. She's following up on it. She can't comment quite yet. But she should be getting in contact with you as soon as she can confirm what she has. And she tells you to be safe.
You too, my dear.
And Mad-Eye just sort of nods, and wherever you're going, please stay in contact and don't disappear for another 100 years.
Yes, I'll never live that one down, will I?
Probably not.
You might have to wait another 100 years, Professor.
Yes, well. I was there when he lost an eye.
And I'm never going to live that one down.
No, absolutely not.
Do you know that he calls you Mad-Eye behind your back? Never mind.
That's Corin. He is a very shot.
His eye narrows at you, Corin, and he says, I know what I'm about, son.
That's awesome.
I think that name, the mouth, it's going to stick, Corin.
I love it.
He has
pointed
mouth.
Ha.
Yes.
Let's go save our friend.
Yes. Let's.
You all go and head to where the teleportation circles are. The gentleman on duty with his back against the wall so he cannot be taken unawares this time.
Good morning. We're here.
Running.
Volandero.
Go ahead.
Thank you. I signed the book.
He eyes the fuck out of you, Corin.
I grin the entire time.
I take my foot out and try to trip him and just walk by.
Who?
Corin.
That's not nice.
It's fine.
That is not nice. Make a dex save, Corin.
I don't know what the fucking dex bonus is.
Oh, this isn't Talon.
awesome. Is that terrible, though? 14!
You sort of trip forward, but you managed to catch yourself.
I punched Talon really hard.
Where?
In the shoulder. I'm not going to punch him anywhere else.
I'm
also wearing plates, so it's just like bang!
It is. It's a sort of metal ringing sound, and both of you get the goddamn stink eye from this guy.
I look at the old poor old guy, and I give that universal old people sign of kids.
All right.
Without having to say anything, I'm just like
whatever, man. I was just trying to get him back for you.
He already did that. I ate shit. He did a much better job than you did.
Well, you know, I'm helping out.
Well, you two fuck about, Fioriel is in danger.
And I start casting the portal for Valandown.
You cast, and familiar magics that have not come to your fingers in so long coalesce as you watch the circle light up, and before you is a shimmering portal.
Right. Straight to a place to get horses, and right out of town. I don't want to deal with any of this right now. We need to get to Fioriel. We're entering the transportation hub or whatever. It's not like I'm taking you straight to my castle. Ugh, I hate saying that word. In and out, everyone. We're not staying. I don't need to get embroiled in my family right now. That's at a later date.
Jump through.
Boom. Oh my goodness. Boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. Boom. As the portal to the Greenbrier Collective closes behind you, you find yourself in the central hub of Valandarrel. It is a beautiful port city. You can already hear the call of the gulls from where you're at. The attendant sort of just looks up at you with an arched eyebrow, seeing that you have come from what looks to be the Greenbrier Collective.
Hello, sorry, I was eating in the portal. I know you're not supposed to eat in the portal.
That's how you get ants!
That's how you get extra-dimensional ants!
Yeah, so no one no one likes astral ants. Anyway. Hello. Sort of reach into my bag, or into my pocket of the thing, and I put on a ring. And I just sort of raise it up and I...
He kind of cranes to look and go, oh, sorry, your lordship.
No need. We'll be leaving right away. Yes. Anyway. Go. Let's go. Let's go, everyone. Let's go.
Running, 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 running.
You guys.
Alright.
Heading out to find, like, horses, I find someone I recognize as being, like, a messenger of the messaging... A mailman. I'm looking for a mailman.
Oh, yeah.
It happens to be a small boy.
We have that guilt. It's not a small boy.
It's a small girl instead. Of 18.
Hello. Do you recognize this ring?
Yes, your lordship.
Please don't call me that. Take this letter to the keep. It will explain everything. Make sure that it gets in the hands of the Lord, Shalandero. Tell him I couldn't stay, but I will be back. Or tell them to tell him. He probably...
You know, I'll take care of it.
Yes, and I give her 50 gold.
Oh, thank you, sir. I'll go right now. And then she starts running. Yes.
Right, that's taken care of. Horses? Southeast. I don't like being here. I don't know if you could notice that. It's been a long time since.
No, you seem totally cool, Professor.
Normally I'm quite calm and collected, Corin. Do not like being here.
You're like an icicle.
I have not been here in 400 years? Something. I have not been here since I left for the Collective. I do not want to see my family right now. I mean,
we'll take care of Fioria.
If I remember correctly, there used to be a nice stable over there. In that direction somewhere. I don't know.
You almost instinctively start to head towards that way, retracing steps. You manage to find a stable offering an assortment of horses and also ponies available for rent and for sale.
I flash my ring and, like, bill it to the account, please.
Yes, sir.
I may not like my family, but I will spend their money.
how many?
All of them.
I'm afraid what you hear when I say is I want every horse is you just want, I want a lot of horses, but I want every horse that you have. No. I'd like enough for us and then maybe like a couple for spare. Just in case.
Of course. Let me go start saddling them up for you. And he goes off, and as he does so, Talmar, you hear a familiar voice you have not heard in a long time, and it is joyous, and you hear Tally! And that's where we're leaving off for the night.
What? What?
I was really shocked that I thought Bucky was happy for a second. Like, there's no way!
Bucky's like, oh, I thought I lost you finally.
Like, oh, where the fuck are we now? What the fuck are we doing? What the fuck do you want?
Can you send me back to Astral Oblivion? It's much nicer there.
I was selling you as a donkey.
I just
this
met
time.
Like the most awesome horse, and I'm thinking about getting horse engaged.
No, I think camel is what Bucky's coming back as this
horse
time.
Engaged.
Horse engaged. Horse engaged. I mean, she already has a really nice set of shoes, so I can't offer her that.
Well, you know.
She's got a mane from the withers to the whatever. I don't know horse terms.
She's so sassy. I love it.
I know Withers is a horse term, but I don't know what part.
We keep abandoning Bucky. Kind of sad. I feel bad for him.
Well, maybe these horses will live this time.
Oh, we need to find out what happened to those horses, I guess.
The only job more dangerous than parent
is horse.
Is a horse for
you guys park. Left the horses in Kaimalar, oh, and they're right. Being well taken care
pony,
of.
Or pony, apparently.
Pony.
Alright, let me stop the thing.
Corn, stop.
I hope you're not mad at me, Christina. I will miss playing with you
next
week.
See you next week.
Bye.
Ari!
Corn has just stopped naming his horses because